somebody and say, well, I'm going to have something reserved. If you think you have something reserved, God says you are not fit for the kingdom. But this guy in the Old Testament, the one who received the double anointing, he slaughtered the animal, he used the instrument to bend the fast and everything and gave it all. And came, and the Bible said he became his servant. He followed him. In the days of Jehoshaphat, Jehoshaphat didn't know Elisha. And they were going to war. And said, is there not a prophet in the camp? And one man said, well, there is a prophet. But this prophet is Elisha, who poured water in the hands of Elijah. Jehoshaphat didn't know Elisha, but he knew Elijah. And the fact that he poured water in the hands of Elijah, he said, then the word of God is with him. Pouring water is serving. He became a servant. He knew he was somebody. But when the man of God anointed came, he came to serve. Amen. You want double portion? You must serve. So people are too big that they cannot even carry their pastor's Bible or carry their pastor's bag or pastor's wife's bag. These things, you think they are just nothing, but they are very important. Amen. Serving in the house of God.
Amen.
Some of us would think, I just came from space and I served some men of God. I drove the pastors who came to Accra and they didn't have cars. Some place they didn't know where they were going. I had to teach them. I carry it to these things you now see things. I carry it every Sunday morning. I have to go and I carry it, come and fix it, play it, and then wait, do everything. 9 o'clock or 9:30, carry it to the place I hide. I remember one of my birthdays that I had to spend time with my birthday. I was even in bed and one of the elders came and knocked on my window. Please, we're going to have to say, can you please come and fix instruments for us and fix, you know, lights and everything? I said, oh, today is my... So no, please, we have a crusade. And I didn't even bath. After pasting, I wore my dress, and I thought I was going to fix the instruments and come back. Before I realized, they have finished the crusade. With my death in my body, I sat there, and after fixing, I played the instrument. When I was coming, so, why? My birthday, especially my birthday, I have to spend it with myself. How can I go and... But I didn't know all this serving was a place for me. Serve! And he served the man of God. After serving, the council meeting from heaven wrote a transfer that this time you are leaving. And somebody has to take over from you. I'm preaching now.
Yes.
Somebody say, my father, my father.
My father, my father.
Then comes my son, my father, my father. And then when he received the council meeting letter, he moved from Gilgal to Bethel.
Yes.
Gilgal is a place where the Lord rolled away the shame. And I pray that the Lord will roll away your shame.
Amen.
And then when you are going to Bethel, Bethel means the house of the Lord, where Jacob met God first time. So they decided to go there. And he said, I will not leave you, I will go with you. And so stay here. And he said, no, I will go with you. So they came to the church, to the all-night prayers. Paraphrasing the word of God. And from Bethel, they found out that in Bethel there were sons of the prophets. And they told him a discouraging word. Because they know they had a letter from the council meeting. And the man of God was leaving. Do you know your master will be taken away from you today? He said, yes, I know. Keep quiet. You don't have to tell me. I also know. I also have the council meeting letter. I'm reading. I should keep quiet. Somebody say Yehovah.
Yehovah.
And then they moved from Jericho, the house of Rahab. A place where Joshua has placed a curse. A place where prostitutes are raised. But they have not forgotten, or they have forgotten that that prostitute came and be engrafted in the family of Israel.
Yes.
So he said, well, I will go with you, because if I go through with you, I will receive it. And when they got there to the information, there were sons of the prophets there. Wherever you go, they will be there. Unless anything. Wherever you go, they will be there. Say, do you know your master will be taken away from you? I say, yes, I know. I don't need anything to tell me what I know. Keep quiet. I also have the counseling in the back. White paper. And then moved and came to Jordan. And to his surprise, there were sons of the prophet in Jordan, about 50 of them. Not one, 50. And there are many people who try to discourage you from receiving the impartation. But God, who has called you, is faithful God.
Yes. Amen.
Keep your faith.
Amen.
Fight the good fight of faith.
Yes.
Contend for the faith.
Yes.
The guy held his feet. He said, no, keep quiet. And then they came to the banks of Jordan. And the banks of Jordan, 450 years ago, Joshua crossed. Nobody had been able to do it. But the man of God knows that what God has done once, he will do it again.
Amen.
If God has done something once, he will do it again. When we're growing up, we used to sing this song. He will do it again. 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 He lives the sea. He raised the dead. I'm glad to say. Change. My God has done a miracle. It is a miracle. He will do it again. He heals the sick. He raises the dead. I'm glad to say He will never, never, never change. My God has done a miracle. Oh, what a miracle.